Tim. Good morning. As Tim mentioned, my name's Joe Grace. I'm the vehicle line executive for both the A and B segment cars, our small cars, and also for the SRT product line. So it's kind of with great pleasure that I get a chance to talk to you today about our newest addition, the Abarth. So what I'd like to do first is kind of ask you to come with me a little closer to the car so we can kind of talk about some of the specific exterior, interior, functional details of the product. So Tim started off with what we think, of course, is the first and foremost, the motor. Mike Vincent, in a couple minutes, is going to take you through kind of some more details on the at the engine stand. But again, 160 horsepower, almost as important, or to me more important, 170 pound-feet of torque. So it's a 70% increase in torque over the naturally aspirated motor. So a tremendous step up in power. And then, of course, with the efficiencies that Tim mentioned with the multi-air system. So really the blend of both. With that comes a new heavy-duty 5-speed manual transmission, the C510 transmission. Upgraded half shafts. The half shafts are 23% larger in diameter, equal length, to prevent torque steer. So again, driveline setup is really commensurate with the package, the power, and what we think the performance that's needed to really have that track capability. One of the things that is critically important, of course, is the intercooling system. It's a twin intercoolers, very kind of nicely packaged. Actually, the inlet for the intercooler is here, and then the outlet for the intercooler is here, so they're actually kind of on a 45 degree angle in each corner of the car. So again, there's a lot going on in the package. You'll get, of course, a chance to look under the hood either before you leave or at the track today, and we can talk more about the package, but really an efficient package. And then, of course, with that, as Tim mentioned, kind of the outflow of the engine, the exhaust system, kind of an Abarth trademark. We really spent a lot of time trying to get the right exhaust character with the motor and with the car, and we think we've kind of really knocked it. It is an aggressive exhaust system, and kind of a step up from what you see in the European model. So real a great package from a driveline performance standpoint. Tim touched on some of the chassis refinements. So it's basically, it's a totally redone chassis. The car sits 15 millimeters lower than its naturally aspirated sport model cousin. The front suspension, we've got now a degree and a half of negative camber, so we've got about 0.9 degrees more negative camber. We've upgraded this 40% stiffer front springs. We have FSD Koni shocks in front to kind of balance the damping forces both on the road and on the track, so we think we've got a nice balance in front. Then the rear suspension, the rear suspension structure has been revised. We've added a 21 millimeter sway bar. We have, again, a 40% in aggregate stiffer rear suspension as well. So the car is hunkered down on the track, and it really gives, again, the character that we need to have kind of a neutral balance. You'll get a chance to experience that certainly at Spring Mountain today. One of the things that we talked about certainly with the 500 base model is that we have multi-modes. We have what we call a normal mode and a sport mode. On both the base cars and the Abarth, it controls the pedal map. It controls the EPS system, kind of the steering assist that you get through the EPS system. And then on the Abarth, real importantly, it also controls the output level of the engine. Mike's going to show you some torque curves here in a few minutes, power torque curves. But what that does is it takes you up to 230 newton meters or 170 pound-feet of torque in sport mode. So you want to certainly exercise that button. That's the button I think most people will find themselves driving in, is that sport mode. So with just as a note, with each ignition cycle, it reverts back to non-sport mode. So when you key back on, just take a look. There's a little display in the cluster when you're in sport mode. So chassis, talked about brakes. Front rotors are 11.1 inches, so it's an inch larger rotor. Of course, vented, larger piston caliper, a larger swept area with the brakes. So a lot of braking power in front. This car is kind of front biased in terms of weight, so most of the braking is done in the front. So the rear brake rotors are actually carryover from the base model, but most of the braking power again is in the front. One of the things that we talked about, Tim touched on, is really the kind of the philosophy we have with respect to the vehicle development and kind of its ability to be run hard on the track. So the cars you'll drive today are really straight out of the box. They're completely production representative. And these cars, we've basically used Nelson Ledges in Ohio as kind of our our track development site, because it's a really, if you've driven there, it's a really rough track, and it beats the cars up pretty hard. So we have qualification testing. So these cars, we actually redone the lower control arms. We've redone some of the structure again, to really make it a car that you can go and ride on the track. It's set up for the track. The semi-metallic pads are set up to really kind of minimize fade. So what we think we're delivering is both, again, out of the box, it's ready to go on the track. Of course, it's tunable. But again, it's set up to kind of live up to the expectations that a customer is going to have on the track. Exterior-wise, we talked about kind of obviously the dramatic change in the front with respect to packaging the intercoolers and getting the flow through the intercoolers. We have, there's a unique rear spoiler to maximize downforce in the back of the car. The drag coefficient is 0.367. So again, it kind of maximize, and again, top speed is around 130 miles per hour. So a real nice performance package in a small car. Tim also mentioned, again, with respect to the interior, we've got a new seat bolstering, both in the seat back and in the seat cushion. There's significant increase in bolstering versus the base car. My favorite feature is the steering wheel, which obviously you'll get a chance to spend some time with today. Real nice design, a real thick rim, real nicely matched to the car. We have a 15.1:1 steering ratio, so it's a quicker steer than the base car, again, kind of tying better to track performance. So what we think you'll find today, again, is a car that's dynamically sound. The power is really nicely kind of matched with the package. So you get a chance, again, both in the city mode and in the track, to kind of really experience the car's capabilities. And it's not going to beat you up on the way out there. One thing that I think we haven't touched on, it does have three-mode ESC stability control. So there's the full on, there's the partial on, which takes the engine management off and gives you a little bit wider parameters. And then if you hold the button in, we'll talk about that at the track, you actually, it'll chime at you and you go full off with the ESC. So again, it's a driver's car. It's set up for the driving experience. We think it's going to really appeal to the performance enthusiast who is looking for a real good value in terms of performance per dollar. So with that, I would like to turn you over to Mike to talk a little bit more about the engine.